Hey, welcome to another Let's Play on Sir Android TV, the PS4 UI, which, only a month late.
You can catch it last here. The video you've all already seen or poked around with yourself, but...
Alright, Xbox. Xbox. Xbox.
It's PS4, man.
PlayStation.
Really?
Yeah.
I didn't know that was a thing.
It kind of became... No! It kind of became a thing.
You bought the camera?
Yes.
So you ended up paying as much for an Xbox One?
No.
Fuck you.
No, because the camera was like $60.
Oh, okay. That's not that bad.
So I can go PlayStation. PlayStation.
PlayStation, power off.
Okay.
It's not working.
No, that's not how it works. Okay, so obviously it's not the perfect piece of technology, but PlayStation. No, damn it, PlayStation. PlayStation. Thank you. What's new? And they can show, and I'm probably gonna blank a lot of this stuff out because I don't want to show people's names, but basically, like, when people share screenshots or unlock trophies or play games or whatever that's on your friends list, it'll show up there.
That's pretty cool. I didn't know it had a feed.
Yeah, and another thing that you can do with this, well, you can use this functionality even with a regular headset. You don't need the camera.
Okay.
So I can go PlayStation. No, okay, you know what? You know why it's failing there? Because I'm saying it as a sentence, so it's picking up everything before it. So if I just go PlayStation, there we go. I can go, no? Fine. PlayStation. Oh, it's ready to activate. Okay, Killzone.
Boom.
BF4. Battlefield. I don't know why BF4 doesn't work.
Is it supposed to work?
No, I don't know, because I think it's developer specific, so I can go Assassin's Creed. No, damn it, PlayStation. PlayStation. Assassin's Creed 4. Battlefield 4. AC4. Battlefield. AC4 Black Flag. Nope. Assassin's Creed 4 Black Flag. Nope. AC4. No, Blacklight Retribution. That's exactly what I wanted. Thank you.
Resogun. Didn't work.
Okay. Now we're okay. I'm gonna start dicking around with this. It usually works a lot better than this, but I'm usually not having a conversation and mixing around words while doing that.
Fair enough.
But it bothers me, like, how specific things can get. So, like, EA does not let this go just to be FIFA. So I can go PlayStation. FIFA. Nope. FIFA 14. I have to say, I think that's developer-specific.
Right.
But even in the PS4 UI itself, it gets kind of specific. So I can go, okay, PlayStation. Web browser. Internet. Oh, what do you know? I can just say internet.
Before, internet?
I think that might have been an update, because before I could not just say internet, I had to say internet browser.
Really?
Yes.
Okay, that's pretty good.
It just detected me saying it again. Okay, so
Can I try?
Go ahead.
PlayStation. Resogun. I really wanted to tell it to turn off. I really...
Well, I mean, I could just say, okay, power... No, wait. Power? Power. Back. Okay, so now what I'm gonna do here, I'm gonna try out, I'm gonna quickly show the new thing with trophies.
New thing with trophies.
Which I showed you before, earlier, but I
No, you didn't! What's the new thing with trophies, Levin?
But I screwed up that recording, I'm not gonna hide that. that trophies now have rarity. So now, I don't want to show too far into that because that might, some trophies might show spoilers. But okay. Like, Heroes Aren't Born, the first sequence trophy for Assassin's Creed 4, it shows us a common trophy, 91.8%. That means 91.8% of people who have played Assassin's Creed 4 have unlocked this trophy, and it goes common to rare to very rare to ultra rare.
It's interesting and how progressively it shows how much people really don't finish the games they buy.
Yeah.
Because the further along you get just in trophies for chapters, I guess, that's what sequences are.
Sections
of the game, like the further along it goes, the rarer the freaking achievement. Or
it drops.
I'm just
off.
Gonna call it achievements, probably. Whatever.
It drops off very heavily by sequence 3.
Yeah. What, people don't like it? Why did they buy Assassin's Creed 4 if they're not gonna play it? What's the matter with you?
A lot of people just buy games and like play the beginning of it and go, all right, sure, why not? Or say fuck it. I've had my fill, or this game is too long, or this game, I don't know, people are weird, or maybe people just don't have enough time. The game's only been out for, like, what?
You see, when I do things, I buy a game and don't play it for nearly a year. Hence, Dead Space 3, Gears of War Judgment, etc.
Okay, so now, one of the new things as well with this is finally PS4 has party chat. And I want to quickly see if I have any notifications. Nope. Okay. I don't want to show people's names, but like I'm seeing like invitations that I've gotten before from parties. But party is basically, it works almost the same way as it does on 360.
Yeah.
Which is, I mean, that's the perfect way to go about it.
It's a good system.
And I'm just going to quickly show, okay, and then you can just send like that. Okay, I'm not going to send it. But now I'm in my own party here, and my voice is being picked up, and okay, so you're just changing it from audio, or from party chat to game chat.
Uh-huh.
I'm not sure what the hell the point of that was, so I'm just gonna back out of this party.
That's easy as that.
Alright, now let's quickly show, let's boot into a game. So, PlayStation. Because I'm so lazy. Assassin's Creed 4. Start.
Oh my god. You know, that took about the same amount of time, if not more, than it would take to push a button.
Yeah, I know.
That's why, ultimately, like, I don't understand.
There are cases where you turn on a system but don't know where a controller is, and you're spending some time looking for a controller, but you just want everything to start and be booted up. And you can just yell at your system while you're looking for your controller.
I guess. Okay.
And then if I wanted to quickly back out.
That I'm actually always impressed by for some reason.
What, does the...
Just how quickly you can go right back to the menu without it actually killing your game.
Yeah, it's really fast and smooth, yeah. And so I don't have to just go back to this menu. I can always go back to the last screen that I was on. So I'm going to go to my profile. And one of the shortcuts, because there are quite a few shortcuts with the PS4 controller. If instead of just hitting the PlayStation button, if I double press it, let's hope that works. Yep. It just goes directly back to the game. And we'll always keep going. No. It will always, every time I double press it, it will go back to the last screen. It will not just go back to the main PlayStation UI. Right. So now I'm only gonna press it once. Main UI. Press it once. Back to the game. Double press it. Back to my profile. The last page that I was on. Double press it. Back to the last thing I was on here.
Awesome.
And I will never register. Wait, no, I think I did register for Uplay at some point years ago. But I'm not gonna log into Uplay. That service is frustrating as hell. So one of the things I've done here is because, you can hear the ambient noise of this system, which is not, I mean, it's all right music, it's calming.
It's pleasant.
It's pleasant, yes. But I'm used to it not being on, so I usually just have that off. I just turn that on for the sake of the video.
I gotta hit on the ambience, man. Who's Evelyn?
She is the main character from Assassin's Creed Liberation.
You can play as her in this?
There is a bonus mission that's specific to the PS4 version.
Cool. Cool.
Which I have not played.
Now Assassin's Creed 4 for a minute.
So, what I'm going to show next here is just, like, the basic share functionality.
All right.
So, I've changed the way the share function or the share button would normally work, and I'm just running around like an idiot here, and I'm going to... It's going to make the video kind of blurry. I wonder how the capture equipment is actually going to pick up on that.
Hindsight.
And the first load of this game is always like the longest. So, I've changed it so that I mainly only use my share button for the sake of screenshots.
Right.
Because, I don't know, the PS4 last 15 minutes recording thing doesn't entirely work the best for me. So, I've changed it so that before, if you press the share button, this would if you just press the share button, this would show up.
Okay.
Upload video clip, which would be the last 15 minutes, which I have not been in the game for 15 minutes. But if you ever back out into the PlayStation UI, it will not count any of that. It will only count when you're in-game.
Okay.
But you can take screenshots of the PS4 UI, but you just can't record clips from it.
Right.
So it would go to this menu where upload clip, upload screenshot, or broadcast gameplays if you want to start broadcasting to Twitch or Ustream, which I don't have a Ustream right. account. I do have a Twitch account. So, but what I've changed it to is just pressing share once, which is do a quick screenshot.
Right on.
Oh God.
What is that?
An ocelot, I think. Wait, no. Okay, yeah, these ones are actually do not attack you.
Getting that guy, I think. What's it doing?
I don't know. Oh, damn it. Okay, fuck it. So
many crabs just walking around.
If I double press it, it starts a manual record.
There was no reason for that. Kill an ocelot with the hidden blade.
Oh, that's kind of graphic.
A little bit.
So, now I've started manual record, right? And if I double press it again... Wait, hold on. Yeah, damn, I did the wrong thing. Double press it again, and I will end that manual record. And that damn ocelot just ran up to me, so I might as well do this.
I guess.
And for manual record, if you don't trust the PlayStation 4's last 15 minutes thing...
Mm-hmm.
You can just have it record infinitely, but it will also only record in 15-minute blocks.
Right, so you'd have to sift through, like, several 15-minute segments.
Yeah, so now I'm going to go back and look at the stuff that I've... ...that I've captured here. This is the screenshot that I just took.
Cool.
Yep. Which, it seems pretty high-res while when you're viewing it on the PlayStation 4, but I think that Twitter has a limitation for the resolution. Uh-huh. So it looks a lot worse when you actually try to get the image yourself. Like, if you want to tweet it so that you can save it yourself.
Right.
Which, I mean, it's still good enough quality. But then, yeah, so my account is directly connected to Twitter, so that I can just type that in and then hit share, and then it would tweet out.
Hashtag PS4 share.
Yep. It has the preset so that you click PS4 share and like
so
most people
no matter
are...
what, you're a tool to the Sony.
Like, most people are too lazy to erase that or don't care to erase that. So you click PS4 share up the hashtag on Twitter and you'll find a lot of people's. So one thing I don't really like about this share button is every time you press it, it will capture a video clip or a screenshot no matter what. So now I've already caught 3 video clips here. So yeah. Now I'm going to quickly go through here. Video takes a lot longer to load. I rarely load video up from here anymore.
Okay.
Oh my God. And look at this. Okay, so I can't actually do this because I don't care to integrate my Facebook account. I'm not going to do that. But what I can...
How
oh, wait.
Dare you?
But what I can do...
That account you never use.
What I can do is I can go to my captures folder and then look at all the videos I've... or whatever that I've captured here. Okay, these were the most recent ones that I got, and then this will just show the one that I captured here. You remember when I did this?
Yes, I do. It actually looks worse than gameplay.
Well, it's compressed video.
Why does it do this, though, if it's the exact same thing running it?
Because the thing to keep in mind is that it has to run the game and record at the same time.
Fair enough.
So we're actually recording at a worse resolution. I can't remember what the resolution is. It's like slightly less than 720, I think.
Okay.
But you could tell the difference right there because the main game was running in 1080p.
Oh, yeah.
And then that video was like a bit under 720.
Seeing them back to back, you could definitely tell the difference.
Which is why now I don't rely on that anymore. One of the reasons why I don't.
Because you've got your own setup.
Of things.
With blackjack and...
hookers.
Matter of fact, forget the recording concept.
Yeah. What the hell else can I show? Oh, introduction. I don't know what that is. And also...
Now, here's one thing I'm curious about, because yep. You're showing me all these things.
Yep.
How easy was it to actually find them?
Find what?
Like, how you knew to check your folder for what you had to view, because you didn't want to integrate your account and stuff like that.
I had to be told.
Okay. Because I'm wondering how intuitive it is, like how much it's just...
I mean,
it just occurs naturally to watch it, to find that, because you know where everything is at this point, and I'm not really poking around or have any objectives, so I'm not really looking at it and thinking, oh, I'll just go here. So I'm not sure how... It's not bad, like, it's at least smooth-looking and nice, but just wondering, like... Because I don't like things gated behind, oh, sign in with this. And I could see myself immediately getting discouraged and just feeling like, fuck it. I don't feel like doing that now.
Because my first thought was to look in here, where I'm at right now, System Storage Management, and then see if I can check the files like that. And it does have your files for capture, but it's only for showing... Well, you can... Wait, I wonder if you can actually look at... Oh, what do you know? You can actually do that.
What?
I didn't know you could actually look at things from here.
Hey, I learned something new.
Alright, I don't have to actually go into the captures folder. But, I would have found that regardless, or I would have found this at least regardless. I mean, it's a folder icon.
Yeah.
And another thing that I really like about this, and the game is still running in the background as well. On the PS4, I would not be able to open the store.
You mean the 3?
On the PS3, sorry. Yeah. On the PS3, actually, you want to know something I did recently? I accidentally, a few days ago, referred to the PS4 as the PS2, and the PS and the PS3 as the PS1. Like, mentally, in my mind, I had in my mind that the PS3 was the first one, and the PS4 was the second one.
Oh, it's relative, I guess.
Kind of. But I really like how much, like, the store is more properly integrated into the UI. Yeah. Like on PS3, if I was in a game, I'd have to exit the game and then boot into the store because the store counted as its own app.
Yeah.
Whereas here, the store is just a part of the UI. So now I can just go back into the game.
That honestly always, like, throws me off a bit that you're suddenly right back into the game.
It's really fast and smooth.
I'm used to playing a 360 where things can take like as long as 3 minutes.
And yeah, the 360 over its lifespan got really... I mean, it started off pretty fast. But the more they added to it... Or maybe... Actually, maybe I should actually look back at that. Because it might have only felt fast relative to its time.
True, yeah.
Because that was like 2006 that I had my 360. My first of many 360s. Why did I do that?
What did you hit him with?
A berserk dart. So if he sees me, that's bad.
What's a berserk dart?
It makes him go crazy and want to kill things.
What sorcery is this? Was it just like too many hits of LSD, realistically? Just gonna drive him mental? You inject him with pure cocaine?
And this is one of the few games that actually, that I've seen actually properly integrates the touchpad on the PS4. So now, like, I'm pinching and zooming with the touchpad with my two thumbs here and, like, scrolling around with it. where now
that's pretty neat, I guess.
In comparison, here's the left stick. Right? Here's the touchpad.
Okay. Now, quite a big difference. I'm curious about how open the world is here. That island I'm seeing outlined on the map. Can you walk around the whole thing?
This one here?
Yeah.
I'm not entirely sure. Well, I mean, there are areas to land on. Wait, yeah, they won't be this all the same area. I don't think you can just walk through the middle of it. You might have to you have to enter that area through one of these outside areas.
I see. I was just hoping you could just trump about through the island. But that would be pretty ambitious. And the game's ambitious enough as it is. Jesus. Like, without warning, just back. Like, I'm used... Ugh.
Hello.
So, these guys are bad, right?
Yes. If I was killing innocent people, it would tell me, this character did not kill innocent people. You are now about to be desynced from the Animus because you have to keep historical. This character is not even real. Let me do what I want, damn it.
Wait, like in the canon of this, they made this guy up?
I don't think this is a real guy. Like, I don't think Ezio was a real guy either, or Connor.
Well, no, not historically, but I mean in the canon of the game.
Oh, yeah, in the canon of the game, you are not allowed to kill innocent people because that is apparently what the... Like, you are not allowed to act outside of what the character would do.
You want to just stand next to each other conveniently? Both looking in exactly the same direction? Look at the other guys are doing it too! Come on now! Stupid game henchmen.
Alright, let's go look for something to buy. I'm not gonna buy anything, but... I mean,
something for Christmas?
Okay, so what we're doing here is... see how snappy and smooth... I'm sorry, I'm a dick.
Snappy smooth.
Like, I just like... Like, it's just integrated into the UI, like... And the PS3 store is also really slow as well.
Right.
And this one's also kind of slow, but still a lot, hell of a lot faster. PlayStation. No.
Would you not remember what you wanted to do?
No. Okay, so I'm just going to quickly do this. Okay, broadcast gameplay.
I think you got to bring his... You got to... Oh, you're just going to literally right now?
Yeah, sure, why not?
Are you telling it to do it?
I'm playing Assassin's Creed. Oh, you mean through the mic?
Yeah, I thought you were telling it to start broadcasting. And I was like, I don't think he's listening anymore.
I have it put Resogun, because I was streaming that at one point as a test. I'm playing Assassin's Creed, but I don't know, whatever, fuck it.
Ubisoft's gonna get mad at you.
Currently, only the microphone audio is being broadcast. Stop broadcasting, hit the share button. Alright, sure. And if I went to twitch.com, I could probably see that.
That would just appear on Twitch? That appeared on Twitch for like just 20 seconds, and then that was it?
Yep.
Hmm.
And then I stopped broadcasting.
Why does he always look like a predator cloak is deactivating when he runs out of cover?
What do you mean?
Like that.
Oh, that?
What is that?
Oh, when he, like, glistens white, it means he's hidden.
Okay.
And it just means he's coming out of a hiding spot.
Okay.
Oops. So, let's see if I can find a place with civilians, which,
gonna kill some civvies.
I don't remember what places have people. Oh, Nassau.
We're
I'm sorry, this
some,
is, this is also
some innocent people.
This is also kind of becoming an Assassin's Creed 4 video.
A little bit. Dazzle me by jumping in and out of menus a few times, though, and then we'll say, this is PlayStation UI.
PlayStation UI.
Oh, wow. That was so fast. Actually, can the game, like, finish loading while you're doing this, or would it pause all that completely?
I believe it keeps running. Some games are set to pause when you do that. I think this is one that just keeps running. I'm just gonna give a random example of, okay, here's a group of people. It means I'm now blended in with these people. And you can see, like, the white dots on the floor, kind of.
How are you blended in? You don't look anything like them. It's like, oh yeah, that man is definitely with them. This weird, hooded, freaking heavily armed guy is just with these guys.
It actually kind of made, it made the most sense in Assassin's Creed 1.
Well, didn't he do a thing where he looked like he was praying and because of his outfit he looked like a monk or something?
Yeah, something like that, yeah. Okay, so here's one thing that's common in Assassin's Creed games, so I'm gonna hire these hookers.
Prostitute.
Or whatever you wish to call them. And now I'm blended in with them.
What? You know, it's just four hookers and this guy.
Okay, I'm gonna find some guards.
What are you gonna do with those hookers?
I wanna have them come to me. Wait, where are you? Them. Distract them. For you, anything.
And here I thought the game was letting you have sex. Why have they all become Fable characters all of a sudden?
I can't think of anything else to show right now, so I'm kind of just playing this.
That's fine. You know, it seemed like senseless violence against those guys. Oh, suddenly raining.
That was, yep, almost as fast as the PlayStation 4 UI in stores now.
Oh, God. Is that what this is?
An ad video?
You're finally making this video because they gave you, like, $25. And they're going to sue you if you didn't make the video. So it's like, hey, here's a VOI video.
Or maybe I'm making the video so that Sony allows me to monetize my videos. No, I'm not.
Definitely it. Definitely it.
None of my videos are monetized. Oh, that was... Oh, he blocked it.
I let him live out of respect.
Alright, that's pretty much it.
So I guess these guys are bad because they're British?
Are they British?
They're in red coats.
They are British.
There you go. that is British. I think he killed some Spaniards earlier. Are you a good guy just because people have decided pirates are good?
No. I believe the idea of the assassins in every Assassin's Creed game is that you're always, like, toying the middle of the line. Not necessarily that you're
except
riding the fence,
except
but
for that time you helped found America.
You're almost always, basically, anti-heroes.
Okay.
You do evil things to just... and they justify the good ends. The ends just justify the means. Yes, that was the phrase I was looking for.
Liberating the town from its guards.
None of this is. People are running in fear. Oh, that woman.
Kill
is
a civilian.
Huh, what do you know? You can't do that in this game.
Really?
Huh, that's weird.
Oh, so it was another game where you did that in...
In every other Assassin's Creed game, you can kill anyone you want.
Huh. How are you just blending in? Like, they just saw you kill random people, you got swords out, and then you just push a button, I am now blending in.
Well, you have to walk in between them. Well, see now these people are afraid of me? Well, okay.
Now you've blended
in. Okay, now I'm blended in. Okay. But the people that were, like, facing me and walking away from me, I could not blend in with.
That just seems so silly to me. This game is freaking gorgeous, though.
Yeah. This game is also pretty silly.
At the same time, though, I guess it kind of helps for them to go in that direction when they've made this many games.
So yeah, that's pretty much it. mean,
look at this PlayStation 4.
All that I had to show probably ended like 10 minutes ago.
Then Assassin's Creed 4 happened. Stabbed a guy. Skinned an ocelot. Made hookers seduce men and then killed them immediately. Yep.
Alright, that's pretty much the end of this. Thanks for watching, and you probably didn't watch the last 10 minutes, because that was kind of just rambling, but if you actually made it to the end, you have earned a verbal cookie. Or I'll give you a text cookie. Follow me on Twitter and I'll tweet you a text cookie.